Hello everyone, this is Razvan, the author of the Penmania blog. Long time no see. I apologize for the delay between this video and the last video. I've been busy with different stuff, but I also wanted to follow up with a special pen that I got for my personal collection, and today I can present to you this fountain pen. This fountain pen is the new Pineider Avatar, the ultra-resin generation, so the collection that was just launched a couple of weeks ago, I think, by Pineider Italy. And it is a fountain pen that I like quite a lot, but I also have some, or actually one issue with the pen. So I want to show you what I'm talking about. This is the box that the pen comes with. It is a normal cardboard box. Yes, we have the Pineider logo here. Firenze, yeah, 1774. The nice emblem and logo on the box. We remove the cap. It's an interesting shape. I saw the previous generation of the Avatar. It had a more luxurious box with the pen. And probably this is to emulate an ancient pen stand or pen desk. And this is how the fountain pen looks. Yeah. For those who write the future, this is written in Italian. Per chi scrive il futuro. And again, we have the Pineider logo, Pineider emblem. Nice presentation, that's for sure. And here we have a small booklet. Let me get the pen out of the way just to show you. It is written in Italian and also in English. It's an interesting material. It talks about the introduction of the 2019 Avatar collection, which marks, as they say, an important step in the pen manufacturing, because it involves this new material, the ultra resin, and their assembling process, which is not using any type of glue. So they call this the glueless process. And they say they have a special protection of the cap lock. They talk about the old celluloid materials that the pen manufacturer used to use, especially between the two world wars. And they say in here that in the 20s, pen makers were used to through pens from an airplane to demonstrate the resistance of celluloid to hits. I think they've done a mistake here. The native English speakers they can correct me if I'm wrong, but this is not a correct verb. They should say they used to throw, actually. THROW pens from an airplane. This is another type of verb. I mean, I can use it in a different context, like I went through a tunnel with my car, you know, I went through something. I didn't throw something. So I think it's a mistake. It's not the best English translation, that's for sure. So here and there are some words which are not okay. And you know, I am careful about this type of details. This is a 100 euros with VAT, yeah, included fountain pen, and from a fountain pen maker which usually is doing premium or luxurious pens. So, you know, quality should be there, including in the translation. So they say that the ultra resin material is extremely rigid, nearly like metal. Again, weird translation. Nearly like metal. Incredibly resistant to hits, very close to call it unbreakable, resistant to oils, inks, electricity, to high and low temperatures, to UV rays, and to any weathering conditions. Okay, sounds very nice. I didn't test it with a hammer, that's for sure. So let's say they said that in terms of colors, they have 5 colors plus deep black. I don't know, the online shop listed this black as being the graphene black, this one here. The graphene black, hopefully you are able to see. Anyway, I have the black version, that's for sure. Okay, they have the glueless technology. They said the cap lock, there is a film. A film has the function to protect the magnet from corrosion and allows a soft touch closure. So this pen has a magnetic cap. They have the clip is sophisticated solid steel clip compensated from inner spring. So again, translation, it's compensated from inner spring. I would say operated by an inner spring. Mechanism built in the cap top of the pen. Okay, the cap band, it's very nice. You'll be able to see it has the skyline of Florence engraved. Very nice touch. We have a number 6 buck nib with customized for Pineider, so with a different design. Okay, we have again a small summary. We can see, this is very important and you'll be able to see why, the trims, the metal trims are palladium plated. Very important. The clip is from steel, which is good. And it has a 2 years limited warranty. This is the warranty part. We are giving Pineider's address, and there is also here an email address and the fax number. And this is the date of the purchase, 8th of March, and this is the pen shop from Italy, which sold me this pen. Okay, so nice characteristics, but poor presentations in terms of the English translation. There are some mistakes in here, some words that are not very okay from my perspective. Let's go to the final product. This is the fountain pen. Very nice pen. I've chose the black because I like the classic business style of this color. I have a lot of black fountain pens, so yeah, that's my personal preference. We have the classical cigar shape of a pen. We have this beautiful clip made of steel, but it should have palladium plating on it. It has the shape, hopefully you'll be able to see, it has the shape of a quill pen. Very nice touch from this perspective. Very usable. No issue whatsoever. this is the mechanism they were talking about, and in here we have that little spring that helps operate the clip. Okay. And then we have this large cap band where we have the name of Pineider engraved, and then we have this beautiful Florence skyline with the dome and all those historical buildings in Florence. Very nice touch from this perspective. Just to show, the origin of the manufacturer and the fact that they are proud of their historical legacy. Yeah. We have the body, which tapers down, as you can see. And we have the end of the body, and we have again metal. I suppose it's still steel, palladium plated. This has two usages. From a design perspective, to compensate most likely the band gap, I would say. And from a usage perspective, to stabilize the pen when you are using it in writing. Now, the resin itself, this ultra resin that they are talking about, feels very nice in the hand. I understand it is injection molded, yet I don't see any type of seam in here. So probably the way they are doing it allows the elimination of those seams that usually you have in injection molded, fountain pens bodies. So you really don't have the impression of having a cheap resin in here, for sure. It looks quite okay. It feels quite okay. It is a good fountain pen. In terms of weight, we have 40 grams for the whole pen, with 10 grams for the cap, so 20 grams for the body. So not the lightest fountain pen, but not the heaviest as well. And for me, it's perfect in terms of balance and writing ergonomy. We have a magnetic cap, as the small Pineider booklet was mentioning, which is also a nice touch. It is my first fountain pen with such a cap mechanism, let's say like that. And it works quite okay. So this mechanism makes this fountain pen suitable for quick notes, for long notes, etc. Doesn't matter. Hopefully you'll be able to see here is the magnet. Over here it is, and we have also a metal section, and this is a steel ring, magnetic steel ring. So the magnet actually holds on this part of the pen. We have this step down, sorry, the step up has this metal ring which is made out of magnetic steel, and here is the final stop of the magnet in the cap when I put the cap on. The section, again, it's a long section around 2 centimeters. It has almost an hourglass shape. I would say it's a cone shape actually. It has this lip to stop the fingers. It is also palladium plated. It is also a piano finish, as you can see. And we have the nib. Number 6 nib. Very nice, as you can see. Suitable for the size of the pen, that's for sure. So it is made by Bock for Pineider, and it is also customized for them. we have the size of the point in there. So this is a steel nib. Again, I want to emphasize that this is a medium point, a medium nib. We don't have a breather hole. There is no breather hole. And I think it's from a design perspective, it's quite busy. I don't know if you're able to see. We have Pineider written on this part of the nib and also on this part of the nib. And then I don't know if it's a flower-like symbol here or, you know, or an insect-like symbol here. So it's quite busy. It looks nice. It writes excellent. Actually, it's well polished. There are no issues in terms of skipping or a baby's bottom or stuff like that. So it looks like Pineider is checking these nibs to make sure that they write flawlessly. We have the standard bulk unit nib, plastic feed, like as you can see. The whole nib unit can be unscrewed from the section easily, no issues here. The fountain pen works with a standard international converter, ink converter, Warwood cartridges. So an ink converter with Pineider on it is included, which is a nice touch. And it feels excellent in the hand. You can use it like that, you know, holding the fingers on the section, or you can use it even like that because it's long enough. It is, let me check, I think it's 135 millimeters without the cap, so which is quite okay. You can also post the cap if you want, and it posts securely and deeply. It adds some weight to the fountain pen, which is expected, to be honest, but it's, for me personally, this is not an issue. So I can write with the cap even several pages without my hand getting any type of issues. And it is also deep. Okay, so that's the length of the cap. So now the bad part, these are all the goods part of this pen, you know, the ultra resin material, the magnetic cap, the design, you know, the nib of course, which writes excellent. But there is an issue, and the issue is, at least for my pen, is with the metal section, which if we are to believe the Pineider booklet, it is plated with palladium, and I know that palladium is a soft metal. And when you cap and uncap the pen several times like that, you know, hopefully you'll be able to hear, you are bound, you know, to touch the magnet to this part of the section. And this is happening every time you cap or uncap the pen. And because of that, and I don't know if you'll be able to see right now on the video, hopefully if I put it like that, scratches will develop very quickly on the section, on the metal section, big scratches. So when I got this pen, because I am a fountain pen collector, I also have an online shop in my native country, I have a magnifying glass, so I want to check my, you know, I usually check the nib, the tines, if they are aligned, etc. So I've checked all the parts of the pen with the magnifying glass, including the section. And I saw that the section was already scratched. There are some tiny scratches, so nothing that you could see with the naked eye. And I say, okay, it can happen sometimes, you know, in the final manufacturing process, this type of things can happen. But after a day of usage, the pen has developed scratches that were visible with the naked eye. Again, if you are not able to see in the video, I will include some images, separate images, so you will be able to see them. So right now, the whole section is scratch in this area. Has scratches all over. So I've got in touch with the pen shop from which I bought the pen, and they've sent another section in. I've discussed with them, I've asked them, listen, this has happened. They've told me that there is another customer that complained about the same thing. So they sent me another section. And that section also had scratches on it. And I put it on the pen. I've capped and uncapped the pen several times, and then it started immediately to develop scratches. So I've sent an email to Pineider. I've used the email address they are mentioning in this booklet for warranty and stuff, info@pineider.com. I think almost 2 weeks ago I've sent an email, nobody answered. I will send them again a follow-up email. I will include this video review and I will ask them to respond. I would like to understand if the scratching of the metal section is something to be expected, and why they and I would like to understand why they decide to use palladium plating for the section. I mean, I think it's from my perspective, it's a bad engineering decision. You know, you test this out, especially if you have a magnetic cap and you decide to use a metal section, you know that this magnet in here will touch the section. It's unavoidable. So why use palladium for the plating or whatever they've used? They've used a very soft metal in here, which gets scratched. I've asked around other people. I saw on Instagram new users of this model, of the Avatar 2019 model. They were not aware about this. They said that someone said that you need to be careful when you cap it and uncap it. Yeah, but this defeats the purpose of having a magnetic cap, which is speed. So that's the whole point. How much careful should I be? Because right now, this is the speed which I need to use, and I'm still touching the section. I think from my perspective, this is the only flaw for this particular fountain pen. Sorry for the interruption, I had a technical issue. So this is what I want to understand. If you have this fountain pen, the new generation of Avatar 2019, please comment and let me know if you are able to see with the naked eye, not with the magnifying glass. I mean, right now I can see, if I look behind the camera, I can see clearly the scratches. I think this is the only weak point, and I would like to understand from Pineider if this is to be expected, if this is what they intended to do when they've produced this fountain pen, or if there is an issue with my cap. Actually, the reason I've bought this fountain pen in the first place is that I saw the video with Brian Goulet and with Dante Del Vecchio discussing about this fountain pen. You know, Dante had one fountain pen like this disassembled fully, and then he assembled it in order to demonstrate the glueless, you know, technology and stuff like that. And I like that a lot. And I like the concept of a resin, which is injection molded. So it's not expensive to produce, which is very resistant to shocks. So if you drop it, for sure it will not break. At least this is what they are saying. So because of that video, you know, I've decided to to buy it, especially because it is a 100 euros fountain pen. It's not the cheapest fountain pen, but it is cheap, relative cheap for an Italian made fountain pen. I say like that. So final decision for me, I like the fountain pen, so I've decided to keep it like that. I won't be able to sell it in the future, that's for sure, because nobody will gonna buy a fountain pen with a scratch section, that's for sure. But I still want an answer from Pineider if this is to be expected. And if you have another one, again, I repeat, if you have such a model, just take a look at the section. You know, it's, you need to do like that at least 5 to 10 times and you'll develop scratches if you have the same issues, and you'll be able to see it on the section. So that is all from my perspective. It was a long review, sorry about that, sorry about the technical difficulty, but I hope you'll find this useful. The writing sample will be in a separate video as usual, and we will keep in touch for the next review. Thank you for your time and patience, thank you for watching, and we'll get together soon. Goodbye.